Thank you, John. We'll see you in just a bit. After a student at Palmetto Elementary School was diagnosed with whooping cough, well, school officials sounded the alarm.
But tonight we're hearing from a local pediatrician who has a warning for every parent. News 4's Angela Rodriguez has the story. And Angela, this is highly contagious, right?
It sure is. The Tdap vaccine was not required to enroll in school until this upcoming school year. According to DHEC, the new requirement is for students entering the 7th grade, but by law, you can opt out, and doctors say the best thing you can do to protect yourself is get vaccinated. That goes for parents, too.
Doctors attribute the recent rise in pertussis cases, also known as whooping cough, to an increase in families opting out of the vaccine, as well as families forgetting to follow up on booster shots.
It's not an epidemic at this point, but we are always suspicious when children or adolescents have a cough that lingers on and on and on.
Doctors at the Children's Medical Center see whooping cough a handful of times a year. The illness presents much like the common cold.
It's droplet spread, so if somebody coughs and you're in that area, you can be exposed to it.
Whooping cough usually takes some time to diagnose and can last anywhere from 6 to 10 weeks.
Adults can have such a violent cough that they can crack ribs.
Doctors say the best defense is the Tdap vaccine.
If your child has been properly immunized, the risks are much lower.
Babies are the most vulnerable because the first vaccine isn't administered until a child is 2 months old, and children under the age of 1 suffer the highest number of complications. That's why pregnant women are advised to get a Tdap shot before they deliver. And doctors are learning as children age, they can outgrow their immunity. So booster shots in middle school and before college are highly recommended.
And so far this year, DHEC has confirmed 79 cases of whooping cough. In 2012, 230 cases were reported. Gabby.